A very good afternoon to all of you. In last lecture, we have started third unit, solutions and chemical kinetics. Okay. Then see, in last lecture we have seen the introduction. Okay, introduction of the chemical kinetics. What do you mean by chemical kinetics? What are the factors affecting the rate of reaction? Okay, because we know that chemical kinetics is very important branch of physical chemistry, which deals with the study of rate of reaction and the factors which influence the rate of reaction. Okay, and this word kinetics derived from the Greek word kinesis, means movement. Okay, then see importance, then rate of, about the rate of reaction. Okay, because we know that as the reaction proceeds, reactant is converted into product. Okay, and we have to measure the rate of that particular reaction. Means the rate of reaction is the rate of change of concentration of any one of reactant or product per unit time, is known as the rate of reaction. Okay, also we have discussed the factors affecting the rate of reaction. Okay, then later on, okay, see what do we mean the rate law expression or rate equation. Okay, before, because before studying the order of reaction, okay, before knowing the concept of order of reaction, you must know the what is the rate law or rate law expression or rate equation. Okay, see, simple. Okay, whenever we write a particular reaction, okay, see, consider this reaction, okay, A plus B, it gives the C plus D. Okay, and what are the small a, what is this capital A, what is the small b? Means why we are written this small letter as well as the capital letter. Okay, see here, the capital A and capital B, these are the reactants. Okay, and whatever the small a and small b, they are the coefficient. Okay, stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, these are the stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, then see, rate law expression, a very simple definition. Okay, therefore you must know the what do you mean by the rate law expression or rate equation. Okay, see. Okay, and these again in the product also, see, capital C and capital D, these are reactant, sorry, these are the product. Okay, and small c, small d, they represents the stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, then see, what is the rate law expression? Rate law is the expression in which reaction rate is given in terms of molar concentration of reactants, with each term is raised to some power, means this power, okay, rate is directly proportional to that. Okay, then which may or may not be same as the stoichiometric coefficient of the reacting species in a balanced equation. Okay, see, a very simple definition. Just first consider what are the reactant and product. Okay, a small letter A, B, C, D, they represent the stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, and in this rate law, suppose this is the rate law expression, rate equals to K, now concentration of A raised to small x and concentration of B raised to small y. Okay, see, in this expression, okay, the reaction rate is given in terms of molar concentration of reactant. Okay, this A and B represents the, that square represents the molar concentration of the reactants. Okay, and this term, each term is raised to some power, that is the x and y. Okay, and this power may or may not be same as that of this stoichiometric coefficient, means this x equal to a small a, okay, which is a stoichiometric coefficient, or it is not equal to the a. Okay, or not necessary, it may be same or may not be same. Okay, which may be same or not same as that of the stoichiometric coefficient of the reacting species in a balanced equation. Okay, have understood? Okay, see the example, 2NO plus O2, it gives the 2NO2, okay, nitric oxide. Okay, then rate is likely, rate is equal to K, concentration of NO2 and concentration of O2 plus. Okay, suppose, see, this 2 and 2 in the product, okay, these are the stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, these numbers are the stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, and here in the rate law expression, the we write the molar concentration of reactants. Okay, but that each term raised to some power, that is the 2 and it is a 1. Okay, and these powers may or may not be same to that stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, it is known as the rate law expression. Okay, make your camera on first, all. Tirumala, Vinayak, Praful, Mohit. Yes, okay. Okay. Okay, understood? What is the rate law expression? Okay, means this, because whenever we study the order of reaction, okay, or if we calculate the order of reaction, then we must know the rate law expression. How we can write the rate law expression? Okay, in simple rate law, in rate law expression or in rate equation, we have to write the molar concentration of reactant. We know that square bracket represents the concentration. Okay, and molar concentration of reactant, but that concentration term raised to some power. Okay, but that power may or may not be same to that of the stoichiometric coefficient in a balanced chemical equation. Okay, suppose in some time, okay, sometime we can easily show the number of molecules involved in that particular reaction. Okay, means here, suppose by simple seeing this chemical equation, you can say the rate of reaction. Okay, means simply there are two number of molecules of NO and one molecule of O2. Okay, but means rate law expression is determined experimentally and not theoretically. Okay, means rate law expression determined by experimentally. We cannot tell about the rate law expression by only seeing a general balanced chemical equation. म्हणजे ही जनरल कोणतीही बॅलन्स एक केमिकल इक्वेशन असते ना, त्या इक्वेशन वरून आपण सांगू शकत नाही व्हॉट इज द रेट लॉ एक्सप्रेशन. ओके, त्यासाठी आपल्याला एक्सपेरिमेंट परफॉर्म करावं लागतात. ओके, आणि एक्सपेरिमेंटली आपल्याला रेट लॉ इक्वेशन कॅल्क्युलेट करावं लागतं. कळतंय? ओके, सपोज आपण, मी म्हणलं की याच्यामध्ये किती नंबर इन्व्हॉल्व आहे त्याच्यावरून आपण सांगू शकतो का रेट लॉ एक्सप्रेशन काय आहे? नाही सांगू शकणार. ओके, बिकॉज इट इज डिफरंट. Okay, because in that whatever in rate law expression, what are the powers to that concentration term? Okay, that powers may or may not be same to that of the stoichiometric coefficient of the reacting species. Okay, it is a rate law expression. Okay, okay, got it? Okay, the next point is the order of reaction. Okay, next point is order of reaction. See, this simply order of reaction. Whenever we study any particular reaction, we must know the its order of reaction, whether that reaction is first order reaction, whether it is second order, or whether it is third order reaction. Okay, means this order of reaction simply tells about the dependence of the reaction rates on concentration of the reactants. Okay, what is the order of reaction, or what the order of reaction indicates? It indicates the dependence of the reaction rates on the concentration of reactant. Okay, and that is expressed in terms of the order of reaction. Okay, if in your reaction the rate of reaction depends concentration of two reactants, okay, then we can say it is a second order reaction. Okay, if I said the rate of reaction is dependent on the concentration of only one reactant, then it is a first order reaction. Got it? Okay, means here order of reaction is nothing but the dependence of the reaction rates on a concentration. Okay, then see, to calculate the order of reaction, experiments must be performed to find out the dependence of reaction rate on the concentration of each individual reactant at a given temperature. Always remember, order of reaction is calculated experimentally, not theoretically. Okay, means see here, okay, suppose there are two NO molecule in this reaction and one O2 molecule. Okay, means we cannot directly say by seeing this particular balanced equation. Okay, I said it is a third order reaction because there are two NO and plus O2 molecule, 2 plus 1 3. Okay, it is a third order of reaction. No, okay, to calculate the order of particular this reaction, we want to carry out the experiment. Okay, we want to find its mechanism. Okay, and in that mechanism we find out the slowest step, and in that slow step how many number of reactants are involved. Okay, on that the order of reaction is dependent. Okay, therefore to calculate the order of reaction, experiments must be performed. Order of reaction is calculated experimentally and not theoretically. Okay, and therefore means after performing the experiment, we must know the dependence of reaction rate on the concentration of each individual reactant. Okay, Then the concentration or dependence of various reactant is given by rate law. Therefore, okay, we must know the what is the rate law expression. Okay, because by using the rate law expression, we can say that the concentration of or concentration dependence of the various reactants. Okay, then the order of reaction can be defined as, okay, then definition, sum of powers to which the concentration terms are raised in the rate law equation to express the observed rate of reaction is known as the order of reaction. Okay, see what is the definition? It is the sum of powers to which the concentration terms are raised in the rate law equation to express the observed rate of reaction. Okay, see here. Okay, these are the concentration terms. Okay, see, rate equals to K, concentration of NO2, then concentration of O2. Okay, see these powers. Okay, that is the 2 and 1. These are the powers. Okay, and if we carry out the sum of these powers, okay, sum of the powers to which the concentration terms are raised in the rate law equation. This is the rate law equation. Okay, rate law expression or rate equation. Okay, and if we carry out the sum 2 plus 1, it is a third order reaction. Okay, means it is a sum of powers to which the concentration terms are raised in the rate law equation. Okay, that is known as order of reaction. See, for example, the rate of first order reaction is dependent solely on the concentration of one species in a reaction. Okay, if the concentration, if the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of two reactants, then we can say it is a second order reaction. Okay. Then, characteristics of reaction order for chemical reaction. There are some characteristics of the order of reaction. Okay. Then first, reaction order represents the number of species whose concentration directly affects the rate of reaction. Okay. Means here, if the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of one reactant, it is a first order reaction. Okay. Means that order, means for, we can say it is a second order reaction. We can say the two reactants are involved in the rate of reaction. Okay, in calculating the rate of reaction. Okay, means we can say the number of species whose concentration directly affects the rate of reaction. If I said the third order reaction, it means that the there are number of three reactants whose concentration directly affect the rate of reaction. Okay, then it can be obtained by adding all the exponents of the concentration term in the rate expression. Okay, means here. Okay, suppose this is the reaction. Okay, this is the example. Okay, this is the rate law expression. Okay, and it is obtained by adding all the exponents. Okay, which are present in the rate law expression. Exponents of the reactant concentrations. Okay, which are present in the rate law expression. Okay, these are the reactants. Okay, an exponent. Okay, we have added these exponents. Okay, 2 plus 1, 3. That is, it is a third order reaction. Okay, got it? Means it is obtained by adding all exponents of the concentration terms in the rate expression. Okay, then third, next, the order of reaction does not depend on the stoichiometric coefficients corresponding to each species in a balanced equation. Okay, or in balanced reaction. See here, okay, see, this is a reaction, it is a balanced reaction. Okay, means the order of reaction does not depend on the coefficient. Okay, as I said, small a, small b, small c, small d. Okay, these are the stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, and here, as order of reaction is calculated experimentally, okay, therefore the order of reaction is not depend on the stoichiometric coefficients of the concentration of the reactants which are present in the balanced chemical equation. Okay, because it is calculated experimentally. Next, the reaction order of chemical reaction is always defined with the help of reactant concentrations and not with product concentrations. Okay, see, because order of reaction, I explained the dependence of the concentration of the reactants, okay, on the rate of reaction. Therefore, order of reaction is calculated only with respect to concentration of reactants and not with respect to concentration of the product. We simply, we want to know the how many reactants are involved in the reaction. or in rate law expression, and on that concentration of reactants the order of reaction also depends. Okay, then next, the value of order of reaction can be in the form of integer or a fraction. It can even have a value of zero. Means it is not necessary that the order of reaction should be have only positive value. It may have integer or it may have fractional value also. Okay, or it can even have a zero value also. Means there are some zero order reactions are also present. Okay, means it is not necessary that it can have only positive value. Okay, it can be integer or fractional value, and also it is can have a zero value also. Okay, see, then there are types of order of reaction.